Shabbat shalom, everyone. I want to share with you an idea, a very important point on this portion of the week, Parashat Shavua Toldot. We read in this parasha about Yaakov and Esav. Both of them were trying to get the blessing from their father, Yitzchak. Their father had one blessing to one kid. That blessing will guarantee the continuation of the Jewish nation from one of those children. He will be the one that will continue the Jewish path and serving God in this world. And of course, the firstborn is always a priority. That's why Yitzchak wanted to give the blessing to Esav. But his wife, Rivka, convinced Yaakov in a tricky way to get that blessing, because she saw that Yaakov deserved that blessing more than Esav. And that's what happened. Yaakov was listening to his mother. He came because Esav was blind. He came to the room to get the blessing. And then, because he was blind, Yitzchak, his sense of smell was very, very strong. He used to smell the people. And he was, of course, a big, big tzaddik, a big righteous person. By smelling people, he could understand what's the spiritual level of that person, of his son. And when he smelled the clothes of Yaakov, it says in the Pasuk, in the Torah, in this parasha, it says, Vayarech et riach begadav, and he smelled his clothes, Vayomar, Reach sadeh asher berecho Hashem. That's a smell of a field that God blessed. It's a field that God blessed, that field. And it says in Rashi, one of the commentaries, that he smelled the smell of heaven. Because when Yaakov came in, the smell of heaven was, his clothes had the smell of heaven, the smell of a field that God blessed. That's what it says. And Yitzchak enjoyed that smell because he understood that his son is such a righteous person. He has the smell of heaven coming in with him. He was happy that his son is going in the right path and he deserves the blessing that he wants to give him. But our rabbis tell us that there's a certain connection between this portion of the week, Parashat Toldot, and the last portion of the week, Chaye Sarah, because we see the same terms of a field also in last parasha. In last parasha, we read about the meeting between Yitzchak and Rivka. When they met, Rivka came on a camel. She saw a certain person going out to do something. And then she asked Eliezer, the servant of Abraham, who is that guy? And Eliezer told her, this is your future husband, Yitzchak. And it says, Vayitze Yitzchak lasuach basadeh. So Yitzchak went out to talk, to pray in the field. So we see the field again in this portion, in that portion of the week, Parashat Chaye Sarah, when in the meeting between Yitzchak and Rivka, it's also happened in the field. What's the connection of the field in the meeting between Rivka and Yitzchak to that smell of a field that God blessed, that he smells when Yaakov comes in to get the blessing? Our rabbis teach us that we can learn a big, big, important message from those two portions, field and a field. What do we learn from that? So our rabbis tell us that one of the most important things in life, maybe the most important things in life, is our kids. We live for our kids. Our kids are the priority for most people. And we give them everything. We work for the kids. We do everything for the kids. We see people that they spend tons of money for education, for different things, just because they want their kids to have a good life, to go in the right path. We want to end this life with a smile, to know that we know that our kids, they go in the right path, they are happy, and they have everything they need. And our rabbis tell us that for a father to see, or a mother to see their kids growing and having good life, going in the right path, close to God, this is the biggest nachat. That's the biggest, that's the best feeling they can feel. Yitzchak felt that feeling when he smelled the clothes of Yaakov. He says, wow, that's the son that I always wanted. I didn't know that he reached those levels. I smell the smell of heaven. This is a righteous son, Baruch Hashem, that I got this son. But our rabbis say that this son, Yaakov, was such a good son, but why he was such a good son? Why Yitzchak deserved such a good son? How did he educate him to be such a good son? It says it depends on that field, the first field. This smell of a field, yeah, heaven. This heaven that I see from my kid, it's because of the field that I was praying even from before I got married. Those prayers build our kids. And this is the connection between the two fields. The first field in last parasha, they're talking about going to the field to pray. This prayer is what's basically guarantees the kids to go in the right path, to be smart, to be educated, to be the way we want them to be. So the prayers building our kids, that's the message from this parasha. And a small story for you. There was one big rabbi, a Moroccan rabbi, Rabbi Baruch Toledano, one of the great rabbis in the past generation. He had, I don't remember the exact number, but more than 10 kids. More than 10 kids. And you know, when you have so many kids, statistically, not everybody would be perfect, right? Maybe 5, 6, 7. Always we have one or two that they don't go in the path of their father. They decide a different way. But it was a very interesting thing in this family, in the Toledano family, that all the kids of this rabbi, Rabbi Baruch Toledano, went in their father direction. Each one of them became a rabbi. Each one of them was a very important person, was very smart. They were writing books. And each one of these kids, not just the kids, even the grandkids of those 10 kids, also each one of them was mamash, like their father and even better, like their grandfather and even better. And the people that are looking from outside, they didn't understand how come this grandfather has such a merit to have all his kid and all his grandkids go and continue his path. What's his merit? What did he do to deserve it? One time they asked him, and he said one thing. Every day I sit on the floor at midnight, which is the most powerful time during the day for prayers. And I do tikkun chatzot, one of the prayers that a man has to do at midnight. And after I finish that very, very special prayer, that very, very special time, I have a list of all the names of my kids. And when I got grandkids, I also had a list of all the grandkids. And each one of them, right after that prayer, at that very special moment, I was praying for each one of them individually to be a reshamayim, to have a fear from God, to have a good characteristics, midot tovot, to be happy in life, to be smart, to have income, parnasa, all the blessings for each one individually. The grandfather, he actually built that family with his prayers. And that's the message for Parashat HaShavua. Our kids depends on our prayers. The more we pray, better kids we have. Shabbat Shalom.